let me touch you with my words, for my hands lie limp as empty gloves.
Mark O'Brien, from an early age, was in an iron lung, but he had a razor-sharp mind, and so he ended up going to Berkeley, and he became a successful writer and poet, and a major part of being a human being is love and sex, and he wanted to know that. And the punchline of the story is that he found out what love was, too.
Let my words stroke your hair, slide down your back, and tickle your belly.
I think Mark was loved very much by people, not always in the way that he wished, but I think his sense of humor, his intellect, and the fact that he was a fighter, I think made people attracted to him. And that's kind of where our movie takes off.
Is it possible for me to know a woman in the biblical sense?
Are we talking about sexual intercourse?
I think so.
There are women in the film who I think project a lot of stuff onto him, and he's just stuck lying there, you know? He's got a lovely caretaker who gets all wrapped up in her own set of ideas about who he is, you know, not really taking into account that there's a full human being there.
Amanda.
This you must have. What? What is
it? I love you.
She does really care for Mark, and he misinterprets her affections to mean more and falls in love with her, and she breaks his heart, but in doing that sort of is the catalyst to him going on this quest to find intimacy. And she does really love him, and she makes an effort to let him know that, but doesn't want to be with him that way.
Ignore my wishes and stubbornly refuse to carry out my quietest desires. I have a new attendant. She answered the phone. Her name's Vera.
Welcome, Vera.
Thank you. She's the quiet assistant who does fall for him, not in a sexual way, and he doesn't love her in a sexual way. It's a very platonic, respectful relationship.
If she does arrive, she'd be perfectly within her rights to turn her out and run.
Mark O'Brien.
Hi, Cheryl Cohen Green. Let my words enter your mind, bearing torches.
I think what this character I got to play does is walks in and goes, wow, okay, this is a really challenging body. Let's go. So I think she actually does see him. She actually does see him and really wants, really truly wants the best for him.
Nice shirt.
As in racy and sophisticated.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
What he writes in his book, which was so moving to me over and over, is just, she was nice to me. Like, that was a big deal, because he was at the mercy of anybody who touched him.
In the little bit that's left, what do I have to show for myself? At the very least, beautiful women who all loved me.
It's a universal quality to love and wish for a love in return.
I mean, I think it's easy to sort of want to champion someone like Mark. It's easy to be in his life and want to be part of it somehow, because I think just the way he lived was so extraordinary.
He got more attention from clever, beautiful women than a lot of able-bodied guys get in their lifetimes, probably without appreciating it.
Maybe this is a bad idea.
I think you've done a great thing. But he could have gotten really lucky, because the ladies loved Mark O'Brien. Go figure.
Would you like me to visit you?
Are you married?
No.
Do you have a steady boyfriend?
No.
Then please visit as often as you can.